The location of the mission may have changed, but search crews continued their flights determined to find something, anything, in the waters off the coast of Perth, Australia.
It has the three windows then, the 1, 2, and 3?
They're the main ones that are used, but we'll also put crew members in all the windows.
Captain Mike McSween, a veteran Canadian pilot on military exchange here, takes us on board the P-3 Orion surveillance aircraft. He will fly to the new search site in just a few hours.
These ones here would be the main ones?
These two right here.
Yeah.
Sitting in these chairs, search specialists will scan the waters as the P-3 flies just 500 feet above the ocean. And when they find something...
They're yelling, mark, mark, mark. Where? What are they actually doing? You said they'll press the switch. What are they actually...
Yeah,
marking?
So they actually... they're actually on headset,
right,
and they call that mark through the intercom system.
Right.
And immediately we drop a smoke. So that goes in the water. It will ignite. So we'll have the smoke that we can visually come back to. And we'll also have a reference point.
And even with the reference point, it's still incredibly difficult to spot the object a second time because of constantly changing conditions. That's just part of the frustration for crews scouring the ocean surface for traces of Flight 370.
Unfortunately, if you don't find something, it brings a bit of a disappointment to the crew.
Disappointment has been the hallmark of this mission so far. The weather conditions less than ideal. The search zone itself still changing, but crews are confident if they keep looking, they will have the capability to find debris and much-needed clues to help solve this mystery.
What does this plane in particular bring to this search? Why is it so helpful?
Well, the sensors on board, obviously, are very effective at for search and rescue. Not only the crew stations, but the camera that we have on board and the radar works really well. It's designed for any submarine warfare, so picking up a submarine. So it will pick up small bits of stuff in the ocean.
As Captain McSween leaves us for his pre-flight briefing...
Hopefully today will be the day.
His optimism is something he says has been a constant companion for crews still searching. Paula Newton, CNN, Pearce Air Base, Australia.